mean, I think.
Are we back in session officially?
Yeah, there's only a few things.
Okay.
So did you want to do goals right now, or do you want to wait and do it at the board meeting? Whatever the pleasure of.
You want to finish this section?
Long as it takes.
I think it could take 15 minutes.
As long as you want it to.
Yeah.
There'll be a few less questions.
There's less questions. Let's go at 10, okay? Rochelle talks really fast.
I promise to control my long-windedness.
Why don't we finish the goals and then the other stuff we can put on a board meeting?
Okay.
Okay.
Are we back?
Yes, officially, please.
Okay, so we're back. Just where are we?
1 o'clock, right?
So we are at.
Yeah, 1 o'clock.
Create international learning, right?
Thank you.
Create international learning and sharing opportunity.
Okay.
The elementary Chinese immersion program will expand to include kindergarten and first grade at Carp and Orton Yaks. Last year, as you remember, we just had kindergarten, we're expanding to first grade. Italian is going to be added to our high schools as a world language option. And opportunities for expansion of exchange programs with students from other countries will be pursued. This came about from the Italian situation as well, so that we are exchanging with them, not adding.
We're working on that.
Right, well, we're exploring it, it's not there yet. The next one is Kelly.
Yeah, sorry guys, I kind of jump in and out here.
That's all right.
We're going to focus an awareness on the social and emotional needs of students, social media, peer pressure, school workload, and substance abuse. A few things that we will be doing this year is the Launce Crews Community Action Coalition will be hosting another call to conversation. This year, the topic will be social media awareness, inviting the entire community, making sure that parents and students are aware of just all the things that can happen with social media, both good and bad. In addition, FAN, Families Against Narcotics, which is prevalent throughout all of Macomb County, has a prescription RX program that they are running, Operation RX. And we are going to be partnering with them to raise awareness of prescription drug abuse, misuse, and what it can lead to.
And they're looking for us to add in just for board discussion, a requirement for participating in any athletic program, a parent and a student program to make them aware of prescription medications and the abuse in athletic programs. And they're trying to promote that throughout Macomb County. There's a number of schools that are participating, and we'll probably see more information on that. Okay.
Does the state have any guidelines for drug testing of athletes? I'm primarily looking at steroids because, yes, in high school, it does happen.
I
unfortunately don't know the answer to that. I'm not here with you.
I have some information. Mike may know too, but this is an on again, off again issue. There's no state rules that say you have to or you cannot. Mm-hmm. So there's no prohibition of it or forced of it either. However, there is a way to construct policy on doing this. I remember my experience is working with Wayne Peters at the NEOLA process, where 2 years ago when we started, there were some policies on this that some districts had. There's some issues with having policies that I can't speak to the details, but it is an individual district decision. There are some policies out there. Some districts do have testing. It is controlled at the local level. And then there's some protections you have to have legally against results and verification of results and things like that.
Because there are those parents who are so excited about their child being maybe an athlete, a football player, who knows that this is their road into college, and may misguidedly use substances, allow their children or encourage their children to use substances that are detrimental and harmful to them.
I think that was the presentation you're at. Yeah. I think you could do it, yeah.
Yes, next, increasing opportunities for student recognition. As always, we are looking for more opportunities to recognize our students at different levels at board meetings. As you all know, we have a significant amount of recognition at the high school level. So we're looking at ways to have more recognition for our elementary and middle school students.
Good idea. Okay. So under the finance goal, which is goal number 3, our first strategy is investigate alternative funding sources and attain new revenue sources. Kelly's got the first two.
Actually, the first one isn't mine.
Oh, that isn't.
We can share that.
Yeah, I tried to. Operating and future capital needs will be assessed in cash flow projections developed. something we need to do going forward to see where we're at in a cash position. And then the next one's yours.
The next one is mine. An annual fundraising and sponsorship plan will be implemented that will create approximately $30,000 in revenue. This is quite similar to a goal last year. Last year was the first year where we were looking for different ways for revenue, where you sell the Noodles and Company, Qdoba fundraisers, sponsorships for our movie night, items like that. What we're hoping to do, this is something that is a part of our budget now, so we're hoping to create a plan so it becomes a well machine over the years.
The next item is creating a business plan for the international program. This is something Eric and I and whoever else we need to be involved in will go ahead and develop. The next item is the renewal of the 18-mil non-homestead millage, which we placed on the ballot in 2016. And then the last one is opportunities will be investigated to preserve the general fund fund balance by assessing funding options from grants and other, grants and local and bond funds. And this is an example of the E-rate, how we, the 750, if we go with that, we might be able to, we'll bond it and then flow that, those funds will get it as a grant through the general fund. The second strategy is control expenses, and obviously we're always looking at controlling expenses, but specifically, Lisa Montas and I, along with Patrice Wada, have been working on a business plan for the early childhood program. That is something that we're hoping to bring forward in the next, in the fall, late fall board workshop. And also something that, this is something really in Mike's area, that we'll be controlling expenses based on parameters for the negotiations with the employee bargaining units. Strategy number four is review energy management options. I believe I mentioned before, we are have discussions with an energy management company out from Fairhaven. We've seen the presentation, and actually we are scheduling a meeting with the superintendent to go over it, and we should, we're scheduled to bring that forward at the board, the September 21st board meeting. So,
any exposure company like that, I'd like to have a an example of who they've been servicing for a while and get some feedback from them. I want to make sure that, you know, it works.
Will we receive a presentation from this company?
We're going to make a recommendation. We're not. My understanding is not having the presentation, we'll be bringing forth the recommendation.
Right.
Okay.
It'll allow us to evaluate, yeah, mm-hmm. But some background on that. We want to do our homework on that. We don't want to, you know, pay a buck to save a buck.
Mm-hmm. What was the company that did do a presentation to us?
Synergistics. Okay.
The next item is mine, and it's something we have talked about a little bit already, highlighting and marketing district programs internally and externally. Internally, we've talked about many different ways that we're planning on making students more aware of programs, and early childhood and alternative education opportunities are two things that we hope to emphasize. In addition, we have the budget that was approved giving money for a radio campaign that will be used to increase awareness outside of just the families we already have here in our schools.
When he even said the radio campaign, school's already starting.
Well, it's we have to be very strategic with that $20,000. We do only get 1 month of advertising. Our schools of choice, everything shut down for schools of choice as of July 31st. Our intent is to use this money for campaign for the following year. So we are focusing on most likely doing it in our open month where we have both the high school lottery seats and the K-8 traditionally falls in the month of May. So the intent is to put our money where it can be best used. Mm-hmm. Okay. Moving on to the fourth goal, community goal. We are in Lawrence Cruz. The first sub-goal is to build and support community involvement with parents, business, government, local agencies, staff, students, educational institutions, as an assembly of informed advocates in public education. The first is to utilize a coalition of informed advocates as key communicators. At this point, we have been compiling that group through different groups that we already have here in our district. Some of those who are part of the strategic planning process, those involved in building utilization, parent advisory, and from there, we are going to conduct multiple meetings throughout the year with our Lighthouse Coalition. One of the focuses this year will certainly be the upcoming village election. Next, creating a community, I'm realizing there's a missing E, so it threw me off. Create and communicate strategic targeted messages. Again, one of our most targeted messages this year, in addition to those that certainly won't fall off, that we are a great community, we are great schools, great staff, is the informational campaign for the non-homestead village renewal. To build relationships with our graduates, we plan on recreating an alumni network. This is something that we had years ago, and we see many reasons it would be great to have back in our community. And we will be involving them in many different activities. One of the ideas in strategic planning was to involve our alumni who are business owners in the Career Day event that we plan to host. Moving on to the next page, we have utilizing signage to create awareness of the district boundaries. As many of you know, we had some difficulties getting that started this year. We were unable to put up street signs as you entered the Lawns Crews community due to state guidelines. But we have found a few ways around it. These schools will all have wear Lawns Crews flags flying on their flagpoles. And we are going to be working with townships to see if we can possibly have our school logo on a sign along with the Harrison Township sign, Clinton Township sign, things like that. Again, that will be subject to approval again, so that's our next hurdle.
What about if you're going to do flags at all the schools for Lawns Crews, why not talk to the townships about when they fly their flags to fly the Lawns Crews?
That's because a great
it
idea.
Is, like, Harrison Township is Lawns Crews.
Right.
That's all that's in
yes.
there.
Yes. Right. Now, and it would be easiest with Harrison Township because I could see a concern, Clinton Township saying, okay, well, how many flags will we have on our pole?
Right.
But certainly with Harrison Township, I can see it being a much easier task.
Did you check whether we can get those additional educational excellence award signs?
It looks like we only get the one sign, but it is in the process of being put up. We're going to make sure that it is seen off of Gratiot, just underneath the electronic sign for Panko and JPAC. That way, all of the traffic that is heading northbound on Gratiot will see it. It'll be better than putting it in front of Panko, in front of the classroom where it was awarded, because it just wouldn't be seen as much.
Sure.
Creating a stronger sense of community, we will be holding further district-wide events. Our outdoor movie night is actually going to go from a spring event to a fall event. We have learned that well, weather is even more volatile in the spring. But moreover, the fact that the sun sets significantly later in September than it does in May, or earlier in September than it does in May. We have just gotten funding through the foundation, so we'll be hosting on September 26th. Over at high school on their football field, our movie night, and it'll be much earlier. It sounds like we'll be able to get a 7:30 start time,
wow.
Just making it more available to our younger kids and families. In addition to that, the career night that I already mentioned, and I've been talking with some of our art teachers about hopefully putting together a district-wide art show here in our building. Involving local, involving businesses. We've talked about possible options of creating a proud Lawns Crews sponsor, something where when you walk up to a building, you can see that this building is proud of being in the Lawns Crews community and supports us. In addition to inviting them to the district-wide career day already discussed, and last year we held a legislative breakfast, and one of the few things that we heard that made very good sense was to add business leaders into this opportunity. They have an important voice and may have ideas that would help in furthering the process that we started at the last one.
There's things you do for fundraisers with businesses. The EDC is having a golf outing that they are inviting all the businesses to play, and they raise quite a bit of money. The Harrison Township EDC, and they raise quite a bit of money because most people play golf. Mm-hmm. Or they know people, and it's a party of four, and pay for the party of four to come and play, and then pay extra for a lunch, a dinner afterwards, or you don't have to attend, and then they have some, one car dealership has a car at one hole for a hole-in-one, and things like that, but it does bring in a great deal of money.
Absolutely.
That would be an option as a fundraiser, and, you know, you and I also get the group of teachers could say, well, we want to play because we're going to represent our middle school. And the business leaders get to meet other people within the district.
I think one of the challenges...
And Gowanus will probably work with you on it.
Fantastic. One of the challenges that we do end up facing when it comes to fundraisers is the fact that not only do we have the foundation that has their events, but we have many of the booster groups have their own golf tournaments and such. There are many fundraisers that are already happening. So the key is to try to find something that maybe isn't being done so we don't take from that community or find that one spot where, okay, if there's a golf outing this month and that month, we can squeeze in the middle and hopefully not take from the other two. So that is something that different fundraising events and ideas I'm always happy to hear about. But that is something that sometimes we come across, that are we going to be taking from one of the other fundraising groups if we were to have an outing too close or too similar? The next one actually goes over to Mike.
Yeah, I think I have that one real quickly. There is a diversity committee in place. They met a few times last year. Last week I spoke with two of the building administrators that are kind of leading that charge, and they've developed a student, parent, and staff survey. And the plan this year early would be to get that out and then use those results to continue the work of the committee and target some strategies and make some
Who's on the committee? Not like names, but like,
pardon me?
Who's representing the who are being...
Who's on the committee?
Thank you. I don't want their names. I don't have
a membership list. Oh. I can tell you that...
What are the groups?
Right.
Is it just parents? Like, is it teachers?
Well,
parents?
It was made very clear to me, and I don't have a list, but it was made very clear to me that membership needs to be grown.
Diversified.
Yes. So I can't give you a specific answer. I have a feeling that there were a few people leading the charge last year. So that's one of our goals, get that going, expand that.
Okay.
And that looks like the last one is me, and we've already talked about this a little bit. Some of our goals, they end up overlapping, but offering social media awareness workshop for our parents. This will be the Community Action Coalition. I'm the administrator for that group, so I'm very much involved with that, but we'll be hosting that. Usually it falls in November. The date, I believe, is to be determined.
Just don't do it during hunting season.
Thanks for the work. I'm very interested in a couple different situations. You indicated you're going to build a business plan. That'll be interesting. I mean, a true business plan is an effective tool. And somewhat, it'll be interesting to see how that evolves.
Would you like any updates now, or would you like to call it quits? Whatever.
Let's call it quits, and then we can cover the rest.
Kind of one minute?
Yes.
One of the things that this workshop, one of the things we should be doing is a board evaluation. It's been pretty interesting. Okay, as you can only imagine. I brought for Amy a copy of her historical board evaluation, so you've got that. But also brought copies on, there's a new model that MASB has put together, and I'd like to share this with everybody, and we'll share it with board members. I like it, and I'd like to, this is really, that's just the cover letter for it. You can see it online. You can go online and see what the questions are and how they give feedback. So please, I mean, so we have a model that I think board members have not been especially happy with. I would propose this model, if anybody else has another model, but I hopefully we could discuss this soon and work on it. So yeah, that's a start.
Thank you.
Yeah. So thank you.
Anything else that anyone needs to add before we end?
Well, thank you for everyone for carving up so much of a Saturday to talk about this important work.
All right, 12:53, you're done.
Thank you.